Hi everyone. Today in this video, we're going to take a look at the story of Peter and the Wolf. Peter and the Wolf is a musical story, which means that it has music from an orchestra playing the whole way through the story from beginning to end, and it was written with the music and the story together. In the picture here, we can see some of the characters in the story. We can see Peter and a red wolf. We can see the grandfather and a cat and a bird and a duck, who are all characters we meet along the way in the story. It says here that over the next 2 weeks, we are going to be learning about and watching the story of Peter and the Wolf. This story is about a boy named Peter. We've already kind of heard about him. He lives in the forest with his grandfather. Peter spends time with his animal friends in the story, and they meet a wolf along the way. And in the story, we find out what happens to them. This story is very special because it was written with music from beginning to end. The music was written by a Russian composer named Sergei Prokofiev. Each character in the story is paired with one or more instruments from the orchestra. When the narrator reads about a character, we also hear the instruments play to match. We're going to take time today and learn about the characters, and we'll see their instruments. So the first character we see and hear about is Peter. Peter is the main character. He's a boy. He's represented in the music by the string family. This includes the violins, the violas, the cellos, and the basses. Sometimes all of them playing together, the whole string family, and sometimes smaller groups of the string family. So here we can see the picture of the string family of instruments. In an orchestra, there would be many people playing string instruments, so we would have a lot of players if the entire string section is playing Peter's music. For the bird, our next character, it is paired with the flute. So the first friend that Peter meets in the story is a songbird. The bird is represented in the music by the flute. Flutes are in the woodwind family, and they often play very high notes, and they can sound something like a bird's song. And here we see a picture of a gentleman holding a flute. The next character we meet in the story is a duck. And the duck happens to be swimming in a nearby pond when we meet her in the story. The duck is represented in the music by the oboe, which is another member of the woodwind family. In the story, the oboe plays relatively low, so that it sounds a little bit like a duck might sound. It's kind of a stretch, but it does sound somewhat duck-like. So there we see a gentleman holding an oboe. And then here we see the clarinet, which goes with the character of the cat. So the final friend of Peter's that we meet in the story is the cat. In the music, the cat is represented by the clarinet, which is another member of the woodwind family. Although the clarinet may look somewhat like an oboe, the clarinet only has one reed that vibrates to make the sound, while the oboe has a double reed, so it has two sides and both of them vibrate when the oboe makes a sound, so the sound is pretty different. Here we see a woman playing the clarinet. And then our next character is the grandfather, Peter's grandfather, who he lives with, and he's represented by the bassoon. So it says, the next person we meet in the story is Peter's grandfather. He's represented in the music by the bassoon, our final member of the woodwind family. The bassoon is the largest and the lowest sounding member of the woodwind family, and when it's used in the story, they play it in a way that kind of makes the grandfather sound grumpy, almost like he's yelling at Peter. So there we see a gentleman playing the bassoon. Then we have the wolf, the bad guy in the story. We do eventually meet the wolf, and he is our villain in the story. He's kind of the bad guy that everyone's afraid of. The wolf is represented in the music by French horns. We see a gentleman here holding a French horn. The French horn is a member of the brass family, so their instrument's made of brass. It is a long brass tube that is bent somewhat into a circular shape, so you can kind of see it has a circular tube, as compared to the other brass instruments, which have different shapes. And our final characters that come up in the story are hunters, and they're represented by the timpani. So it says Peter meets a group of hunters in the forest, and they help him deal with the wolf. The hunters are represented in the music by the timpani, a set of very large kettle-shaped drums. These drums represent the sound of the hunters shooting in the forest. So here we see a woman who's playing two timpani drums, although sometimes in an orchestra you may see as many as four or five timpani. So here we're going to see if you can remember all of the characters in the story. We're going to listen as we hear each instrument one by one, and we'll get to hear what the instruments actually sound like in the story.
This is Leonard Bernstein, and I'm going to tell you the story of Peter and the Wolf. Now, usually before this piece begins, the speaker explains how each person or animal in the story is described by a certain instrument of the orchestra. But I'm sure you know all that already, don't you? Well, all right, let's see if you do. For instance, who's being represented by these three French horns? Wolf. And what is this oboe describing? Right again, the duck. And now the flute. Batting 1,000, the bird. Now, who's this low character in the clarinet? Right, the cat. Then, of course, there are these well-known drum beats. What's that all about? Correct, the hunters shooting their guns. Now, who is this lumbering old bassoon? Grandfather. My, you really know this piece, don't you? Well, that's all of them. Except, wait, I left out the most important one of all, the strings. And that is Peter himself. I congratulate you on a perfect quiz. And now the story begins.
So there we have it. Our final slide here shows us Sergei Prokofiev, the composer. So he's the person who really created the story for us, and he's where all of this comes from that we're learning about today. It says, Sergei Prokofiev is the composer of the story. Composers are people who write music. Prokofiev was born in 1891 and lived until 1953. He was born in Russia, but he also lived in Germany, France, and the United States during his life. He wrote Peter and the Wolf in 1936. Prokofiev played the piano and also enjoyed playing chess, in addition to his music. So here it shows us that next week we will listen to the whole story, so we actually hear what happens to the characters, and we'll find out what happens with the wolf. And here you can see their instruments are with them in this picture. So we'll see you next week for the whole story.